Alright, in this lesson I'm going to teach you how to play the Tom Petty song, Free Fallin'. And basically the verse is just an F chord, and it's gonna be a little variation on the F chord. It's going to sound like this. That. And all I'm doing is I'm holding down F, and that's the first chord you're going to have to learn. So what I want you to do is bar your first finger across fret 1 on strings 1 and 2. So it goes down on both strings, strings 1 and 2, fret 1. Then take your second finger and put it down on 2nd fret, 3rd string. Okay? Then take your third finger and put it down on 3rd fret, 4th string, like that. And strum strings 4 through 1, and there's your F chord, like that, okay? It's a little bit hard to get with this bar, but if you make sure the fingers are on their tippy toes, meaning these knuckles are bent, you're going to have a lot better time getting to it, and it's sounding good. Whereas if you're grabbing it like this, you'd be muting some strings. So make sure all the fingers are on their tippy toes. By tippy toes, I mean the tips of the fingers, right? Okay? Now, what Tom's doing is he's strumming F. So strum it twice, then take your pinky and put it down on 3rd fret, 3rd string, strum it again, take pinky off, it's back to that F chord, and then what you're going to do is take 2nd finger off, and you're basically leaving, you know, all the fingers, basically you're just holding the F chord and you take the 2nd finger off, and you leave finger 3 and 1 down, okay? So what's happening here is you're holding down F the whole time, strum it twice, put down pinky on 3rd fret, 3rd string, strum it again, take pinky off, then take 2nd finger off of 3rd string. And you want this 3rd string to ring out open, okay? So it's looking like this when the 2nd finger's off. Okay, so what's happening is, all that Tom's playing is, what's changing in the F chord is, you know, which is like the hook of the song, that lead melody. So really, it's just, if you wanted to play the lead without playing the F, it would look like this. Fret 2, string 3, and you play 2, 2, 3, same string. We're going to stay in the same string. So 2, 2, fret 3, 3, 2, and then 0. Okay? So that's all that's happening. And when you play that, you use 4th finger and 2nd finger. So it goes just like that, okay? Now I'm going to show you another way of playing this. We're going to play it with a capo. And I want you to, if you don't have a capo, then just ignore this part of the lesson. But if you have a capo, something like this, what I want you to do is capo fret 3. Okay? And what we're going to do is we're going to hold a D shape. This D shape chord, we're going to hold this at fret 5 and 6. So we're going to put our first finger on fret 5, string 3. Our 2nd finger on fret 5, string 1, and our 3rd finger on fret 6, string 2. And we're going to strum strings 4 through 1, just like with the F chord we strum 4 through 1, same with this D shape, alright? And what we're going to do here is play . So basically what's happening is we're just playing an F here instead of over here, you know. Now we're playing a higher form of F. Same chord at an octave. Okay, so you're holding your D shape, right? And you're going to strum twice. Then you're going to drop pinky, fourth finger down, on 6th fret, 1st string. Strum it again. Take pinky off. Then take 2nd finger off. And you want to hear that 1st string ring out. So it's going to sound like this. So it's the same thing we were doing down here, except now we've capoed, and we're playing it like this, okay? Now, all that's going on for the lead melody would be, and you hear that as you play this D-shaped chord. It's actually an F chord right here at fret 5 and 6. Okay? Alright, now, you know, it's easier to play it without the capo, I think, on fret 1, and it gets you ready for the bridge, because when the bridge comes, you can't really use... It's hard to play the bridge when you're capoing across fret 3, so if you play the verse here like this... And this is an F chord, and this was an F chord, but now we're just taking this F chord and playing it here without the capo. So when the bridge comes, the bridge goes like this. Okay? And that's hard to do with a capo on 3. You can't really get to a power chord on fret 1. Okay, so let's take a look at the bridge. The bridge is going to go fret 1. To fret 6. And all we're doing is playing a power chord, an F power chord on fret 1, to a B flat power chord on fret 6, string 6. Okay, so finger 1 on fret 1, finger 3 on fret 3, so string 6 and string 5, finger 1 on fret 1, and on string 5, finger 3 on fret 3. And you're going to play, strum it 3 times. Slide up to fret 6, strum it 4 times. Okay, and you're keeping the same power chord formation. You're going to go back to fret 1, play it 3 times. Go to fret 8, play it 4 times. Like that, okay? So fret 1, 3 times. 4 times fret 6, 3 times, 4 times fret 8. Okay, all together it sounds like this. Now you only do that twice, and then we go back into... So it sounds something like this from the verse or the chorus. The verse is the same thing as the chorus. It's just this F form over and over again. And we're going to go right into the bridge. We're going to play it 2 times and then go back into the verse. So it sounds... Okay. Okay, and that's it. So did you see how we went right back into it? That's going to be a hard transition going from here, you know, this bridge right back into that F chord. And especially since, you know, F is sometimes kind of a, this F is kind of a difficult chord to hold, especially with this barring the first finger and jumping right back to it right away. Might be a little difficult, but that's pretty much the whole song. So good luck with that and have fun.